Hello everyone and welcome to the channel, and here is Google Apps Updates Roundup number 61, and in this episode I'm gonna show you tons of new features in 12 different Google Apps. So let's find out what's new. The first app we have today is Gcam version 8.7. That version was only exclusive to the Pixel 7 for a while, but finally Google released it to older models, and I will start with the non-tensor ones. Here I have the Pixel 5 to show you what's new in this version. The first thing you will notice is the interface changes that we first saw on the Pixel 7. Some of them are already here, like the pill at the top now shows the icon of the camera mode you are in. So when I change to portrait, it will change. As you see, it looks like a camera, now it looks like a person, and this is the night sight look. And also we have the video. As you see, it shows the video resolution here in the pill, which is something new to 8.7. Change number two is the hidden locked folder. We no longer have an icon at the top right corner to activate the locked folder, but instead we need to tap and hold to switch to the locked folder, and it will ask you to activate it for the first time. And once set, you will see the locked folder icon over here. Change number three is the ability to lock the focus on any object in any camera mode. So as an example, I will use the Stadia controller, and when I tap and hold, as you see, I'm getting here a lock icon, means that the focus will never change when I move the object or the camera. And that's also the case in all camera modes, and all you need to do is to tap and hold. This is no longer activating Google Lens shortcut as we used to, but now we can use it to lock the focus. Now let's move on to the Pixel 6 models to show you what else you will get with 8.7. I'm not going to repeat the things I mentioned on the Pixel 5, but I will add to them. And the first change here, when you go to the motion mode, you will see the same new shutter key we first saw with the Pixel 7 models. And here I have the Pixel 6a to show you one more change. When I go to the video and then go to the video settings, as you see, I can use the speech enhancement with the 4K 30 recording, which was only exclusive to the Pixel 7 models, and finally it made its way to older ones. But this new change is not available on my 6 Pro for some reason. Maybe we need to wait some time until Google pushed the feature to all models, and as you see, speech enhancement is not yet available, but at least we know it's coming, so maybe you need to give it some time. And the last change, when you double tap on the viewfinder, now it zooms to 2x automatically, but you will notice something weird here. When you go to settings and then go to gestures, you will no longer find the double tap option over here, even though it's still working in the viewfinder itself. So that's everything new when it comes to Gcam 8.7 on older Pixel models. But let me also talk about the missing things. First, the zoom slider is still the same old one. It didn't migrate to the newer look of the Pixel 7 and 7 Pro. And also when you switch to night sight, we don't have the option to modify the time like the Pixel 7 models, but we can only turn on or off. And finally, here I have the 7 Pro to show you even more recent changes that Google pushed to the Pixel 7 models. And by the way, this is the Mac back case of my 7 Pro, and I have to say this is one of the best cases I have ever used. It supports the MagSafe functionality, so you can attach a wallet to the back of your phone and it works perfectly well. I'm gonna talk more about it later in the sponsor chapter, but let's get back to the Gcam to show you what's new. The first change we have is in the zoom slider. If you take a look here at the example photo on the screen, and when I put it on the same zoom level on both, which is 9.1, as you see, I can see from 2x up to 30x clearly in the zoom slider, instead of only up to 5x like in the example photo. So it's a small tweak, but it will show you a bigger range while using the slider. Change number two is in the macro settings, and now we have much more flexibility. As you see here, we have three choices. The first one is to turn off the macro mode completely, and when you make the subject very close, it will tell you that the macro mode is off, and you can tap on this icon to activate it if you want. And the second option is automatic, so it will automatically activate the macro mode when the subject is close to the camera, like in this case. And lastly, you can lock the macro mode so it stays activated all the time, so you don't need to worry about the phone turning the feature on or off while adjusting your camera, and that will be better in some situations. So now we are done with the changes in Gcam 8.7, and now it's time for today's sponsor, the MacBack case for the Pixel 7 Pro. MacBack is one of the best cases you can purchase for your Pixel 6 and 7 models, and there are many reasons for that. The case has a matte finish with minimal branding on the back, and it shows the beauty of your Pixel 6 and 7 camera visor, which makes it look elegant. Not to mention that all the cutouts and buttons are perfectly aligned, with a loophole attachment for straps, which is a nice touch. The case is made from silicone for maximum shock absorption, with a raised lip for the camera and the screen to protect the most exposed parts of your phone when dropped. And as the name suggests, it comes with built-in magnets that give you a lot of possibilities. First, you can attach your phone to any metal surface for easier usage, or you can use the included mag stick that you can mount anywhere on your car's dashboard or non-metal surfaces to act as a mobile holder. But this is not everything. MacBack also sells their own leather wallet that has two pockets and it can hold up to 6 cards and some cash. The wallet is RFID protected, so your cards are safe from any unauthorized actions. It also works as a kickstand to hold your phone in portrait or landscape orientations. It has a finger loop to securely hold your phone, a cutout for easier access to your cards, and with the wallet attached, you still can use it with the mag stick or attach your phone to any metal surface, so I like the attention to details here. And when it comes to the magnets, they are extremely strong, so you don't need to worry about dropping the phone or detaching the wallet while using it. The case is also available for certain models from Samsung and Apple, and keep in mind that the wallet and the case are MagSafe compatible, so you can use them with Apple phones and accessories without any issues. If you are interested in the MacBack case and all of its accessories, you can use my special promo code InDepthTechReview15 to get 15% discount on all orders. All the links and the promo code are in the description below. And now let's get back to Google Apps. Now let's talk about Google Photos. And the first change is the new styles in the collages feature. When you select the photos, tap on add and then collage, you will see 4 different styles for the new year. This is the first one. Here's the second, the third, and the fourth. Change number 2 is on iOS, which is the ability to share your memories via link. And this is something I talked about in my previous episode. I showed you how it looks on Android. Now let me also show you how it looks on iOS. When you open any memory and then tap on share, you will get the share memory option. It will show you this screen, which will allow you to navigate the memory and also edit the photos selected here. You can deselect or select whatever you want. You can also edit the name of your memory before sharing. And once done, you can tap on share and it will ask you if you want to create the link and then give you the sharing options. Next, we have YouTube, and it got plenty of new changes. The first one is in the shorts. Now you will see media controls in the shorts, and they are oriented vertically to match the direction of the next and backward buttons. And also you have a play and pause button over here. So if you're gonna take a look here on the previous version, you will see the screen is completely blank. The only downside is I couldn't hide these controls when I tap anywhere on the screen. As you see, they are prominent, so maybe Google need to give us the option to hide them in the future. Google also updated the media controls for the normal videos. The first change here is the jump forward and backward 10 seconds buttons. As you see here, those are new, and if we're gonna compare that to the previous version, we didn't have this before. We can only use the gesture. Not only this, but now to dismiss the media controls, you cannot tap anywhere to do this action, but you have to use the X at the top right corner, which is something new as well. Change number 3 is a new feature called Queue. This feature is in beta and Google is testing it now. If you are a premium user, you can enroll yourself by tapping on try it out, and you should find this card in your home feed, or you can simply go to youtube.com/new and you will find it over there. Once you activate the feature, it will tell you exactly what you can do here, and you can also turn off or send feedback to enhance it in the future. So let me show you how it works here on my 7 Pro. So let's say you want to create a queue of videos. All you need to do is to tap the ellipses next to it, and here you have play last in queue. So I'm gonna add this one and then scroll down, add another one, and then go to the now playing screen, and at the bottom you will see the queue is over here. You can tap on it, and here you can do a few things like the ability to reorder the videos by using the handle on the left side, like this. You can also swipe to the left to delete any of the paused videos. You cannot do the same swipe on the currently playing one. You have here the repeat and shuffle buttons, but you cannot, for example, download the whole queue or share the whole queue with others. It's only available for individual videos when you tap the ellipses over here. Change number 4 is only available when you use dark theme. So let me play one of the videos, And if you take a look here on the progress bar, it has a red color. But when I dismiss the media controls, it turns into white, and that will be less distracting if you are using dark theme. And the last change is in the Discover feed. When you get recommendations from YouTube like this one and then start playing the video, you will see also redesigned media controls with the same 10 seconds buttons. And also to dismiss the controls, you need to use the X, but this time it's not located at the top right corner, but instead it's next to the progress bar. Next, we have YouTube music. And now when you go to the now playing screen, as you see, I have a new suggestion here, says connect to stereo speakers. So if you have compatible devices on the same Wi-Fi network your phone is connected to, you will see this new floating suggestion. And when you tap on it, it will start casting immediately. And instead of tapping on the casting button at the top right corner and then choose the device, but now you will get an easier shortcut. The second change I'm going to show you is a new category in the home feed called similar to the now playing history. It seems like Google is integrating the now playing feature of the Pixel phones with YouTube music. So all the songs that got identified in the feature will be recommended here. And this is something neat. I'm not 100% sure if this is a new feature or not, but this is the first time for me to see it. Next, the Google app. And you will see a redesigned home screen with a much thicker search bar at the top that looks a lot more modern and easier to identify. And then you have a carousel of options that will take you right away to different shortcuts inside Google Lens. You have one for shopping that will take you to the shopping tab. You have one for the translate, another one for search a photo, just a regular search. Then you have solve homework. And finally, we have the identify song option that when you tap on, it will start listening right away. Now let's move on to Google Assistant, which is also part of the Google app. When you go to your Google Assistant settings and then scroll down, you will see a new option here called Parental Controls. And when you go inside, it will tell you what you can do with this Parental Controls option. First, you can choose what your child can do. You can choose the displays and the speakers your child can use. And finally, teach assistant to recognize your child. So when you tap on setup, it will take you through a wizard. The first step is to either create a child account if you don't have one already set up on the device, and it will take you to the Google account page, or you can simply continue with the steps if you already have one activated. So let me add my child account and continue with the steps. So now I added my child account, and when I tap on setup, I can choose the one I want. So I'm gonna tap on test child. So I'm gonna tap on got it. So here it says music is off limits, video is off limits, and also the news. So if you want to edit the media, you can choose what type of music your child can listen to. You can play any music or play some music. And when you tap on some music, it will give you more options like the YouTube, Spotify, or Apple Music. You can also adjust the content settings, like for example, choosing to hide the explicit words and stuff like that. So it has it, it's gonna take its time. So it says here, preschool, younger, or older. So if you're gonna choose, let's say, this option and then tap on select. And when it comes to the search, would you like to activate the search or not? So I'm gonna use search off. And then we have the parent feature. Tap on next. And finish setup. So that when it comes to the media, later on you can modify all these settings in the Google Assistant settings app. You can also continue here with the videos. You can do the same thing for videos. And also you have the news and the podcasts. When you scroll down, you have the assistant feature. Can only answer calls, can only answer basic questions. Actions for families are off limits. You can also edit this and choose whatever you want, and so on and so forth. Once you tap on save, it will take you to this page to teach Google Assistant to recognize your kid's voice, and also choose what devices your kid can use to ask Google Assistant some commands. So when you tap on I agree, it will take its time. And once done, it will ask you to hand over your phone to your kid to start the voice match process. Like this. And once done, your kid will be able to be recognized by Google Assistant and give limited access to your kid, different from the one you get yourself. And later on in the settings, you can go to the assistant devices to add or remove whatever device you want. So if you no longer want your kid to use this device, simply tap the ellipses and tap on remove, and it will be taken off, and you can change the device later if you want, and also modify whatever settings you did during the initial setup. Next, the Google Home app on Wear OS. If you have a Pixel Watch and your Google Home app is set up, previously when you open it, it will first show you the rooms and you need to drill down to access your devices under each room, but now it will show you everything stacked on top of each other right away, so you don't need to go inside the room first. And as you see here, it will show you a label to name the room for you, and then you can scroll down to take the action immediately. And if there is any device in your list which is not linked to any room, it will also appear over here, so you don't need to keep moving between different tiles, but you can take the action immediately. Next, Google Maps. And I'm gonna show you a set of features that I've never mentioned before. When you go to your Maps settings and scroll down, you will see a new option here called Electric Vehicle Settings. When you go inside, it will allow you to choose what type of plugs your electric cars use. You can choose one or more, whatever you want. So if you choose two, they will appear over here. So next time you search for a charging station, it should give you the charging station that fits your plugs. The second change is under the navigation settings. When you scroll down to the route options and tap on any of them, it will give you a hint over here that you can use your Google Assistant to allow or avoid highways, tolls, or ferries. So for example, when you turn off, it will tell you here that you can say the magic word and then avoid highways, and it will turn on the switch. And once you say allow, it will turn it off, and the same applies to the other two options. From here, you can also choose your assistant default media provider. You can choose between YouTube Music and Apple Music. I have Spotify installed on the device, but it doesn't show in the list. So maybe Google will add it in the future. But if you are using the Google Assistant driving mode, you will be able to choose the service you want. Next, Google Contacts. And now you will see a new tab called Highlights. Under Highlights, you will be able to see the recently viewed contacts and also the recently added ones, and you can switch between them using those two buttons. At the top, you will see your favorites. From here, you can remove any of your favorites by tapping on Remove, or initiate a call right away from here, or you can add more by tapping on the Add button. Next, Gmail. And it got a neat delivery tracking feature. When you get an email from your courier, you should see a banner here at the top that will give you quick shortcuts like the ability to track the package or view the order on the courier website. And in some cases, you might see also a bar that will show you the progress of your package, when it will arrive, what's the estimated delivery, and so on. And you can see now on the screen an example photo. And I do really like this feature, and it makes your life a lot easier. If you want to activate it, you can simply go to your settings and then choose the email account you want to modify this for, and then scroll down until you see package tracking. Just put a tick over here and the feature will be activated. Now let me show you a couple of random tweaks before ending this video, and the first one is in the At a Glance widget on your Pixel phone. When you tap on Customize, then Settings, scroll all the way down, then see More Features, and then scroll down again, you will see a new toggle here called Food and Household Orders. It says here Delivery and Pickup Status. Actually, none of my apps is utilizing this feature yet, so if you saw it, please let me know in the comments, or you can send me a screenshot on social media to include in my future videos. But that will be a very nice feature to have and see it in action. And finally, when you search for the weather in google.com on your mobile phone, you will get a redesigned card that will show you new icons, and it's organized differently. As you see here, you can check the weather for each day by tapping on the filter at the bottom. Here you have dedicated tabs for the precipitation, wind, and humidity. And here at the top right corner, you can see a summary about the current day. So that's pretty much it for today. Those are all the new features I wanted to show you. Please let me know in the comments if I missed anything. And if you spotted any Google app feature, please let me know in the comments or reach me out on social media to include in my future episodes. But for now, thanks so much for watching, and see you in the next video.